Hello, I'm Amara Jones, and today is Wednesday, February 11th. This is Caffeine TV, your daily news brief, here to take you the three headline numbers in just 3 minutes, giving you a different take on everything from housing policy to the Real Housewives. Well, today we're celebrating the 100th episode of Caffeine TV, and we're really excited about that and want to thank you for making sure that we got here by watching. The first number of today is 3. That's the number of years of a military use of force authorization that President Obama is requesting from Congress today for his campaign against ISIS and what amounts to essentially a formal declaration of war against that organization. And the president request comes just 1 day after the announcement of the murder by ISIS of 26-year-old American Kayla Mueller, an aid worker who was the last known American hostage held by the organization. Now, what's interesting about the president's request of Congress is that many of its members over the past year have criticized the president for not being tough enough on ISIS while not wanting to go on the record for voting for the use of force themselves. I guess the memory of Iraq still lingers, but essentially now the president is telling them to put up or shut up. Now, the bad news in this request is that its 3-year limit shows that President Obama is expecting the campaign against ISIS to go past his time in office. And if you add up the 3 years of this authorization with the 15 years of war that we've been in Afghanistan, that means that the United States would have been in active war in the Middle East for almost 20 years. But the good news is that there is a 3-year limit. So unlike some other wars, this one doesn't seem like it'll go on forever, we hope. The next number up today is 6, as in 6 years. That's the length of time that NBC News announced last night that it was suspending Brian Williams for what some euphemistically call misremembering key details of stories that he's reported throughout the years. Other people just call it lying. Now, with this 6-month suspension and given his $10 million a year contract, Brian Williams is going to be out $5 million from his pocket this year. Now, what's interesting is that while the straight news man was suspended for giving us entertaining stories, the entertainer who actually gave us the straight news, Jon Stewart, announced that he was stepping down last night after 17 years of anchoring The Daily Show on Comedy Central. And nothing underscores the crisis in American news like imaginary stories taking hold in American newsrooms while other channels devoted to our imagination actually gave us the news. Well, I guess that was Jon Stewart's point all along, and he'll be missed. Now, it looks like the people at Comedy Central are going to be looking for a new host of The Daily Show, and I'd just like to underscore that I tape Caffeine TV hours before they do The Daily Show, and I'm usually free around that time. The last number of today is 69, as in $69. That's the amount of a tapestry on sale at Urban Outfitters, which mimics the pattern and design of uniforms of LGBT Europeans held at Nazi concentration and death camps. Yep, that's right, the horizontal stripes and upside down triangle are on sale. Now, not surprisingly, the Anti-Defamation League has called on the organization to not sell the fabric, but someone needs to tell Urban Outfitters that Holocaust chic is not a thing. It's not the first time they've done something like this. They put the Star of David on a t-shirt. They also sold blood spattered design t-shirts with the name of an American university where a massacre took place in the 1960s, Kent State, and they sold sacred Navajo symbols on liquor flasks. Well, this is clearly all a publicity stunt, which means that we should all stop talking about it, which is what I'm going to do right now.